We want to solve 2 sine theta minus square root 2 equals 0 on the given interval. So the first step is to solve for sine theta. So we'll add square root 2 to both sides of the equation. So we'd have 2 sine theta equals square root 2. Now we would divide both sides by 2. So we have sine theta equals square root 2 divided by 2. Which means we want to find all the angles in this interval where the sine function value equals square root 2 divided by 2. Well, since the sine function value is positive and sine theta is equal to y divided by r, the y coordinate must be positive, and therefore our solutions must be in the first or second quadrants where sine is positive. Next, since the sine function value is square root 2 divided by 2, this should remind us of function values that we find on the unit circle as well as from reference triangles. And those are the two main methods for solving this type of trig equation. We can use a unit circle or we can use reference triangles. In this video, we will discuss both methods. But let's start by looking at the unit circle. Again, our goal is to find the angles where sine theta is equal to square root 2 divided by 2 on the interval from 0 to 2 pi. On the unit circle, since the y coordinate is equal to sine theta, we're looking for points on the unit circle where the y coordinate is square root 2 divided by 2. So starting in the first quadrant, notice how this point here has a y coordinate of square root 2 divided by 2, which means sine theta equals square root 2 divided by 2 when theta is 45 degrees or pi over 4 radians. And then in the second quadrant, notice how this point has a y coordinate of square root 2 divided by 2. Again, this means sine theta equals square root 2 divided by 2 when theta is equal to 135 degrees or 3 pi over 4 radians. So these are the two solutions to our equation on the given interval. So we'll go ahead and write these down, but then we'll also discuss how we can find these using reference triangles. Again, where pi over 4 radians is equal to 45 degrees, and 3 pi over 4 radians is equal to 135 degrees. Now, having a sine function value of square root 2 divided by 2 should also remind us of a 45, 45, 90 reference triangle, as we see here. The sine of pi over 4 radians, or 45 degrees, is equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse, or in this case, 1 divided by square root 2. But we should recognize by now that if we rationalize the denominator, this is equal to square root 2 divided by 2. Which means if we sketch a 45 degree or a pi over 4 radian reference angle in the first and second quadrants, where y is positive, we can also find our two solutions. So let's go ahead and do that. So we'll sketch a 45 degree or a pi over 4 radian reference angle in the first quadrant and the second quadrant. Again, we know it has to be in these two quadrants because sine theta equals y over r, and since the sine function value is positive, the y coordinate must be positive. Now let's also sketch our reference triangles. And now because these are 45, 45, 90 reference triangles, we can label the legs length 1 and the hypotenuse square root 2. But we do have to check the sine of the legs based upon the quadrant. Well, in the first quadrant, both x and y are positive, so these are both positive 1. But in the second quadrant, since the x coordinate is negative, this has to be negative 1. The y coordinate is positive, so this stays positive. But notice in both reference triangles, the sine function value is 1 divided by square root 2 here, as well as here. 1 divided by square root 2, which if you rationalize the denominator, is equal to square root 2 divided by 2. Therefore, our two solutions are here, pi over 4 radians, or 45 degrees, which we found on the unit circle, as well as here at 3 pi over 4 radians, which again we already found on the unit circle. I think it is important to understand how we found these solutions on the unit circle as well as using the reference triangles, because if this trig function is not one that we recognize on the unit circle, we will have to use reference triangles to find our solutions. I hope this explanation was helpful.